Welcome back, Tigers. In this video, we'll explore how to add reference columns to the forecast page. These columns allow us to display custom data in the forecast tab. We'll cover adding columns for a stretch goal and last year's actual sales amount. And then we'll add calculated columns to show how close we are to meeting these custom data points. Let's dive into configuring these features for our revenue teams. All right, here we are on the forecast tab in Salesforce, and we're looking at Lila Pouncer's forecast. We can see that she's got $1 million quota, and we loaded her quotas in a previous video. One of the requirements for adding custom data into Salesforce is that you have to have quotas already in. You will not be able to use this feature if you don't. You will also need to make sure that you are on an Enterprise Edition or higher. You cannot access this feature in a Developer Edition or in Professional or Essentials. Now, you also need to make sure that you are using API version 58 or higher for Data Loader, and you have to have the permission Manage Forecast Custom Data. Let me show you what that looks like. We'll go to the System Administrator profile, and here's the permission that I'm referring to right here, Manage Forecast Custom Data. You will need that in order to add this custom data in. What we recommend doing is doing an export of your forecasting quota information. We're going to use Data Loader here to export the object called forecasting quota. Okay, here is all of our data in our object that we loaded for all of our sales reps. I'm just going to delete some of these columns that I don't need. We're not using a forecasting group in our example. We don't need the ID. We don't need these. If you are using a forecast type with a product family, you will need to keep that column. And also, if you have territories enabled and you're using forecast types with territories, you'll need to keep that column as well. We're not using either one of those, and we don't need our quota quantity either. All right, so these are the quotas for all of our sales reps for each month because we have monthly quotas that we imported. Now we're going to add two additional columns for our sales reps called last year amount and stretch goal. Now you need to add these amounts here. I'm going to do these really fast here while you jam out to some tunes. Okay, we have our spreadsheet ready. Now we need to create the fields that we need in order to hold this data. You're going to go to Object Manager, and you're going to type in Forecast, and you're going to go to Forecasting Custom Data. You'll go to Fields and Relationships, and you'll click New. And then we'll create another currency field called Last Year Amount. Save there. Okay, our two new fields are created. All right, our next step is to import the data. We're going to go to Insert, and we're going to look for Forecasting, and we need the object called Forecasting Custom Data. Now I need to make sure I save my file as a new file here. All right, let's go ahead and select that file for Data Loader. We're going to map our fields here. Need to make sure we map the owner ID. And then if you're using product family or if you have territories, make sure you map those fields as well. So these are all the fields that we need to map. We'll click Next. I just have to do this step because this is a new Data Loader because I just installed the new version of Data Loader for this video. All right, so this says 48 successful inserts. We can view our successes, and we should be all set there. Our next step is to go to our forecast settings, and we're going to go to Manage Custom Columns. And you can see that we have three calculated columns. We're going to add now a reference data column. Now here's where you select the field to reference. So the first one I'm going to use is my stretch goal. I can click Save, I can add another column and I'm going to add my last year's amount. I'll click save there. And then in order to make these two columns show in the forecast page, I need to go ahead and add them as columns to display. All right, let's go back to our forecast page for Lila. Let's refresh and let's see if those two values are there for us. Awesome, so we can now see last year amount and our stretch goal. Now let's say that we wanted to create a calculated column based on one of these reference data columns. Now that gets to be a little bit more complicated, so we'll explain how we're gonna do that. What we first want to do is create a calculated column that is going to show us the gap between our stretch goal and our closed opportunity amounts. So we're going to come back to our forecast type. We're going to go to Manage Custom Columns. And in order to show you this, I'm actually going to have to delete one of my other columns because there's a limit of only being able to add 5 custom columns to a forecast type. So I'll go ahead and I'll delete Weighted Pipeline. And then I'm going to add another custom column. This is going to be a calculated column, and this is going to be called Gap to Stretch Goal. And the data type is going to be a currency. And then I'll give you the formula for this down below, but don't just copy and paste this because you have to make sure that this is correct. Now I'm going to give you a couple of links. Here's one link I'm going to give you. Now, this is important to understand how we're going to reference our reference data in our formula. So you can see that custom reference data gets assigned these values, extension currency 0 or extension number 0, depending on what type of field that you're creating. Now we got to go, well, I don't know which one is which. I have 2 fields that I created. How do I figure out which one is 0 and which one is 1? Well, we're going to run a query in the developer console. I'll give you this query down below in the description. And so we're going to select ID, forecasting type ID, master label, result field, and formula from forecasting column definition. So when we run this query, we can see all of our calculated columns, and then we can see our stretch goal has a name of extension currency 0, and last year amount has a name of extension currency 1. And so we were correct in our formula that our stretch goal minus our closed amount is the calculation that's going to happen here. If we wanted to reference last year's value, then we would make this say extension currency 1 in both of these places. We're going to leave that set to 0. We'll click done there. And then let's go to our columns to display. We have our gap to our stretch goal. We will move this up. Then we'll come back here and refresh the forecast tab. We can see here our stretch goal minus our closed is going to be our gap to stretch goal. So that is correct. Now let's do one more calculated column for our last year amount. We're going to have to delete one of these others to show you this one. We'll delete pipeline coverage, and then we're going to add a custom column. This is going to be a calculated column, and this will be called difference to last year amount. This is going to be a currency, and then our formula is going to be forecast amount 0 minus extension currency 1. So this is the closed amount minus, we go over here to our last year amount, the result field value here. We'll click save there, click done. We'll go to columns to display, we'll add that. We'll refresh here. And then we can see the difference to last year. So we are down $563,804. So that's how you import reference custom data and then create calculated columns and reference data columns in your forecast pages. That's it. That's a wrap. Make sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on our next video, where we'll show you how to create custom report types for forecasts and quotas. We'll demonstrate how to build an actual versus goal report and a forecast report that includes opportunity data. If you have any questions or suggestions for future Salesforce topics, leave a comment below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.